Can You Dig It? By Ray Lankford. Did you know there are all kinds of creatures living right underneath you? It's true. You just have to dig a little to see them. Dirt is full of living things. There are wiggly earthworms and tiny insects such as ants. There are also larger animals living underground, such as groundhogs. They live there because that is their habitat. Other creatures have habitats above ground. You might observe squirrels collecting nuts or birds making nests in trees. You might even spot bees and butterflies flying around flowers. All the creatures and plants you see in these habitats are part of an ecosystem. In an ecosystem, all the creatures and plants living there depend on each other. For example, plants drop their leaves and fruit on the ground. As those decay, it gives the earthworms something to eat. The earthworms and insects fertilize the soil, which helps the plants grow. Who knew that worms could be so useful? But earthworms aren't the only ones who fertilize things. You can fertilize your garden by making a compost pile. The plants grow vegetables and fruit that you get to eat. There are ecosystems everywhere. What kinds of creatures can you identify in an ecosystem near you? Word bones. Quizmo. When you're exploring an ecosystem, it's important to watch your environment closely. What's another word for this? Touch. Identify. Observe. That's right! When you observe something, it means you watch it closely or see it happen. All the living and non-living things that are found in the same place are part of its ecosystem. Creature. Waste. You got it! Ecosystem. Can You Dig It? By Ray Lankford. Did you know there are all kinds of creatures living right underneath you? It's true. You just have to dig a little to see them. Dirt is full of living things. There are wiggly earthworms and tiny insects such as ants. There are also larger animals living underground, such as groundhogs. They live there because that is their habitat. Other creatures have habitats above ground. You might observe squirrels collecting nuts or birds making nests in trees. You might even spot bees and butterflies flying around flowers. All the creatures and plants you see in these habitats are part of an ecosystem. In an ecosystem, all the creatures and plants living there depend on each other. For example, plants drop their leaves and fruit on the ground. As those decay, it gives the earthworms something to eat. The earthworms and insects fertilize the soil, which helps the plants grow. Who knew that worms could be so useful? But earthworms aren't the only ones who fertilize things. You can fertilize your garden by making a compost pile. Then the plants grow vegetables and fruit that you get to eat. There are ecosystems everywhere. What kinds of creatures can you identify in an ecosystem near you? Word bones. Quizmo. When you're exploring an ecosystem, it's important to watch your environment closely. What's another word for this? Touch. Identify. Observe. That's right! When you observe something, it means you watch it closely or see it happen. All the living and non-living things that are found in the same place are part of its ecosystem. Creature. Waste. You got it! Ecosystem.